Now we will discuss square root of the number. See here, square root of the number, the sign of the square root is this. See, this is the sign of the square root. Now our question heading is, find the square root of the given numbers. Means 49, 36, 144 and 441, their square root we have to identify. First we will identify square root of 49. Now, first normal method I am going to explain how to identify square root of 49. Which two same digit we can multiply and 49 will come. So see here, 7, 7 ja 49. So square root of the 49 is 7. Now I can explain regular method to identify square root of the 49. To identify square root of the any number, first we will identify prime factor of the given number. So first we will identify prime factor of 49 by prime factorization method. See here, 49. So prime factor of 49 we can identify by prime factorization method. And this method already you learned in 6th standard. See here, 7, 7 is 49, then 7, 1 is 7. So 49's prime factor is equal to 7 multiply 7. Now see here, 7 multiply 7 means 7 square. So 49 is equal to 7 square. Now we want to identify square root of 49. So we will apply this square root sign on both sides. So here see, square root of 49. This we can read as square root of 49 is equal to square root of 7 square. I apply square root sign on both sides, on 49 and on 7 square. Now see, square root of 49 is equal to, now see here this side, square root means 1 half. Square root means what? 1 half. This 1 half we can multiply with these two. See here, 7 square and with 2 we can multiply this 1 half. 1 half means what? Square root. Now these two to cancel. So square root of 49 is equal to 7 raised to this 1 left. 7 raised to 1 means 7 1 times. So square root of 49 is equal to 7. See, square root of 49 is equal to 7. To identify square root of 49, normal method is what? Which two same digit we can multiply and 49 will come. So 7, 7 ja 49. So square root of 49 is 7. And with regular method also, we can identify square root of 49 is equal to 7. Now second, we have to identify square root of 36. First normal method. Which two same digit we can multiply and 36 will come. 6, 6 is 36. Means square root of 36 is what? 6. Now with prime factor method, we can identify square root of 36. First we will identify prime factor of 36 by prime factorization method. See here, 36. Now see here, 2, 18 is 36. 2, 9 is 18. 3, 3 is 9. And 3 1s are 3. See, 2 18s are 36, 2 9s are 18, 3 3s are 9, 3 1s are 3. Means prime factor of 36 are, 36 is equal to 2 multiply 2 and 3 also 2 times. See here, 2 also 2 times, 3 also 2 times. Means 36 is equal to 2 multiply 2 means 2 square. This multiply, 3 multiply 3 means 3 square. Now we want to identify square root of 36. Means we will write square root sign on both sides. See here, square root of 36 is equal to square root of 2 square multiply 3 square. Now square root means 1 half. So 1 half we can multiply with these two and 1 half we can multiply with these two. So square root of 36 is equal to 2 square and I can multiply this 1 half, I can multiply these 2, multiply then multiply 3 and 1 half I can multiply with these 2. See here, 1/2 I can multiply with these two, multiply then multiply, 3 square and I can multiply 1/2 with 2. So see here, 2 cancel. So square root of 36, here 2 and 2 cancel, so 2 raised to 1 multiply, here 2 cancel, so 3 raised to 1. So square root of 36, 2 raised to 1 means 2, 3 raised to 1 means 3. Now see here, 36 is equal to 2 3's are 6. Square root of 36 is equal to 6. Now 2 raised to 1 means 2 one time. 3 raised to 1 means 3 one time. So 2 one time and 3 one time. So square root of 36 is equal to 2 3 ja 6. So square root of 36 is equal to 6. To identify square root of 36, normal method is which two same digit we can multiply and 36 will come 6. 6 ja 36. So square root of 36 is what? 6. And with regular method also we can identify it is 6. Now next 144. To identify square root of 144, first normal method. Which two same digit we can multiply and 144 will come? 12. 12 are 144. So square root of 144 is what? 12. Now with the help of the regular method we can identify square root of 144. So first we can identify prime factor of 144 by prime factorization method. Already I identified, see, 2, 1, 2, 3, 4 times 2, 1, 2, 3, 4 times 2 and 3 times and 3, 2 times. Now 144 is equal to 2 multiply 2 means 2 square, this multiply. 2 multiply 2 means 2 square, this multiply. 3 multiply 3 means 3 square. Okay. Now we want to identify square root of 144. So we will apply square root sign on both sides. See here, 144, square root of 144 is equal to square root of this 2 square multiply 2 square multiply 3 square. Now square root means half. So half we can multiply with these two and these two. So see here, 1 for square root of 144 is equal to 2 multiply this 1 by 2 multiply 2 and 1/2 I can multiply with these two. Multiply these 3 and 2 I can multiply this 1/2. Means 1/2 I can multiply with these two. 1/2 I can multiply with these two. 1/2 I can multiply with this 2. Now see here, 2 cancel everywhere. 2 cancel. So square root of 144 is equal to 2 raised to 1 multiply 2 raised to 1 multiply 3 raised to 1. So square root of 144 is equal to 2 multiply 2 multiply 3. So 3 2 is 6 2 is 12. So square root of 144 is equal to 12. See here, which same digit we can multiply and answer 144 will come? 12. 12 are 144 and our regular method answer also 12 came. Now see next question, 441. So 441 prime factor already I identified. So 441 is equal to 3 multiply 3 multiply 7 multiply 7. This 3 3 and 7 7. Now see here, 441 is equal to 3 multiply 3 means 3 square. 7 multiply 7 means 7 square. So 441 is equal to, now we want to identify square root. So we can apply square root sign on both sides. So this side also 441, apply square root sign. And this side also 3 raised to 3 square multiply 7 square. Now square root of 441. Square root of 441 is equal to, now square root means half. So half I can multiply with these two, half I can multiply with these two. So this 3 and 2 and 1/2 multiply 7, 2 multiply 1/2. Here 2 cancel, here 2 cancel. So square root of 441 is equal to, here 1 left and upside here also, see 3 and 1 multiply 7 and 1. Now 3 and 1, 3 raised to 1 means 3 we can write one time, here 7 we can write one time. So square root of 441 is equal to 3 multiplied 7. So 7 threes are 21. So square root of 441 is equal to 21. Now another short method I can explain how to identify square root of the number. For example, 441. So see, it is the pair of the 7, it is the pair of the 3. Select one. Here 7 you will select and here 3. See, 7 threes are 21. If you don't want to do in this way, then after identifying prime factor, from 7, 1, 7 select, from 2, 3, 1, 3 select, 7 threes are 21. Now to identify square root of 144, see, it is the pair of 2, it is the pair of 2, it is the pair of 2. From this 2, 1, 3 select, from 1 pair here 2, from this 1, 2. See here, from this 3, 1, 3, from this 2, 1, 2, from this 2, 1, 2. 3 2s are 6, 2s are 12. Answer same key. Now 36. From this pair of the 3, 1, 3 select. From this pair of the 2, 1, 2 select. 3 2s are 6. See 6 answer key. And here see. From this pair of the 7, 1, 7 you select. See. Answer is 7. So this is the normal method to identify the square root of any number. I hope you can understand this. How to identify the square root. Thank you. Now we will discuss to identify square root of number with normal method. See here, square root of the number. We have to identify square root of 1, 4, 9, 16, 25, up to 289. First we will identify square root of 1. Our normal method is which two same digit we can multiply and 1 will come. See here, 1 1's are 1. So square root of 1 is 1. Now 4. Which two same digit we can multiply and 4 will come. See here, 2 2's are 4. So square root of 4 is 2. Now 9. Which two same digit we can multiply and 9 will come. See here, 3 3's are 9. So square root of 9 is 3. Now 16. Which two same digit we can multiply and 16 will come. 4 4's are 16. So square root of 16 is 4. 25. Which two same digit we can multiply and 25 will come. 5 5's are 25. See here. 5 5s are 25, so square root of 25 is 5. 36. Which two same digit we can multiply and 36 will come? 6 6 are 36, so square root of 36 is 6. 49. 7 7s are 49, so square root of 49 is 7. 64. 8 8s are 64. See. 8 8's are 64, so square root of 64 is 8. Now which two same digit we can multiply and 81 will come. 9 9's are 81, so square root of 81 is 9. Now 100. So which two same digit we can multiply and 100 will come. So 10 10's are 100, so square root of 100 is 10. Now we have to identify square root of 121. Which two same digit we can multiply and 120 will come. Then 11, 11's are 121. So square root of 121 is 11. 144. So 12 multiply 12, then 144. So square root of 144 is 12. Which two same digit we can multiply and 169 will come. So 13 multiply 13 is equal to 169. So square root of 169 is 13. Now which two same digit we can multiply and 196 will come. So 14 multiply 14. So square root of 196 is 14. 225 means 15 multiply 15. So square root of 225 is 50. Now which two same digit we can multiply and 256 will come. So 16 multiply 16, then 256 will come. So square root of 256 is 16. Now which two same digit we can multiply, then 289 will come. So 17 multiply 17, then 289 will come. So square root of 289 is 17. So it is my request to you, you must remember up square root up to 1 to 289. Then it is helpful to understand the Pythagoras theorem. The square and square root we can directly use in Pythagoras theorem. It is not available in textbook, but we must use square and square root in Pythagoras theorem. So we discussed square and square root. I hope you can understand square root of the smaller number with our normal method. Thank you.